Hi, my name is Brandon Fisher. I work at TI with temperature and humidity sensors. And today I'm going to talk to you about how to use one of the most popular analog temperature sensors, the LM35, with Arduino. In the video today, we'll begin with a discussion of the LM35 in general, including its accuracy, capabilities, and pinout. Then we'll discuss how to properly configure the ADC on the Arduino in order to minimize the amount of error being introduced into our temperature reading. Then I will show you a quick demonstration of the LM35 being read by an Arduino Uno. And finally, we'll go step by step through the code so that you can reproduce these results with the LM35 on your own. The LM35 is a 3-pin local analog temperature sensor and is available in a TO92 package. This makes it easy to use with breadboarded projects or for anyone who wants to avoid surface mounted components. In fact, the LM35 is in general very simple to use and understand. It requires only 3 connections, one for supply, which could be anywhere between 4 and 20 volts, one for ground, and one connection to read the analog output. This setup is sufficient for the device to work from 2 degrees C to up to 150 C. But the LM35 is capable of working from negative 55 to 150 C with the use of additional components or sources. In our case, we'll use the 5-volt pin on the Arduino Uno as our supply voltage. This pin can provide up to 40 milliamps of current, which is plenty for the LM35, which draws only a maximum of 60 microamps. Now, the LM35 has a typical accuracy within 0.5 C for temperatures around 25 C. Which we'll be working with today. The ADC on the Arduino will also introduce some error, and we'll discuss in a moment how to minimize that. But the analog signal can be read back easily and with reasonable accuracy using the analog read function. Once we have a value returned by the ADC, we can find the temperature easily due to the high linearity of the LM35's transfer function. In order to use an analog temperature sensor with a digital platform such as the Arduino, one of the major factors to consider is the ADC. Now, the acronym ADC stands for Analog to Digital Converter, and as the name implies, ADCs are used to convert analog signals into digital ones. The graph on the left-hand side of this slide shows the LM35 transfer function. Notice that the potential output voltage of the LM35 goes up to 1.5 volts. Now, the default reference voltage for the ADC on the Arduino Uno is 5 volts, and in the context of an ADC, the reference voltage is the value that the input voltage will be compared to. The output of an ADC expresses the input voltage as a fraction of this reference voltage. The equation shown below the LM35 transfer function describes the relationship between the input voltage and the digital output of our ADC. Note that the quantity n in the equation is the resolution of the ADC in bits. The Arduino Uno has a 10-bit ADC, so for us today, this number is 10. In general, we want the resolution of the ADC we are using to be higher in order to minimize the error that it introduces. The graph now shown on the right-hand side of this slide shows the ideal transfer function of an ADC that has 5 bits of resolution and a 5-volt reference. Each step represents a specific number that the ADC will return for a given range of input voltages. These are referred to as codes. Now, since the reference voltage of an ADC is 5 volts, and the LM35 outputs only a maximum of around 1.5 volts, we won't use most of these codes if we use a 5-volt reference. The gray portion of this transfer function shows these unused codes. Now, one of the ways we can fix this is to use a smaller reference voltage. An ideal reference voltage would be around 1.5 volts, the maximum expected output for the LM35. But for convenience today, we'll use the 1.1 volt internal reference on the Arduino Uno. The line in blue, now on the right-hand graph, shows that we use all of the possible codes when using a 1.1 volt reference. But the downside is that because this voltage is less than our maximum expected output, we can no longer go up to the maximum 150 C. Using an internal reference of 1.1 volts in the setup we discussed in the previous slide, we'll only be able to go from roughly 2 degrees C to 110 degrees C. Now, the upside to this is that if our project doesn't run the risk of exceeding 110 degrees C, then using the internal reference increases the accuracy of the ADC's reading significantly. Now, if you want to go lower than 2 C, you can do so using a negative supply or by connecting diodes between the ground pin on the LM35 and system ground. For examples of these systems, you can check the LM35 datasheet included in the description of this video. Here we have an Arduino Uno configured to read from the LM35 and output the measured temperature to a generic 1602 LCD display. From left to right in the first row, we have a 50K potentiometer, the LM35, and the LCD. The potentiometer is necessary for the LCD display, which is outputting the measured temperature about once a second. Now you can see the LM35 is reading out the room temperature of about 25°C or 77°F, and we should be aware that both the ADC and the LM35 are likely to be most accurate around room temperature. So as we move further and further away from 25°C, we're likely to see increasing difference between the actual temperature and the return temperature by the system. However, this difference is still not significant when compared with other temperature sensing methods, such as thermistors or the temperature sensor onboard the MCU used by the Uno. In practice, it's a good idea to place the LM35 in direct contact with the device or component whose temperature you want to monitor. using a compound such as thermal grease between the two devices can maximize thermal conductivity and by extension minimize the error in your temperature reading. The schematic for this setup is included in the video description. Now we will step through the sketch loaded onto the Arduino Uno during the demonstration you just saw. So prior to our main body of code, we include the liquidcrystal.h library. This library makes controlling the generic 1602 LCD display from the demonstration extremely simple. Next, we define the pin on the ADC we want to use to read the LM35, in this case A1 was selected, and we also declare our connections for the LCD display and then initialize a global variable to hold the temperature reading from the LM35. Within the setup block, which is the code we want executed only one time, we first switch the ADC to use the internal 1.1 volt reference by using the analog reference command. Then we initialize our LCD display by using lcd.begin, and next print the label for our temperature data. Inside the loop block, we first take a reading from the ADC and store it in the variable temperature. Next, using the equations from slide 4 that describe the ADC output, we solve for temperature and calculate our temperature in degrees Celsius. Finally, we print the temperature as read by the LM35 and print it to the right of the label on the LCD display. The loop will then delay for 1 second and repeat, updating the temperature reading about once a second. Now as you can see, configuring the Arduino Uno to read the LM35 is fairly simple. Out of this block of code, only these 3 lines of code are necessary to read the LM35 and return the Celsius temperature reading. This means you can easily integrate the LM35 into any of your projects where ambient or component temperatures might play a significant role. This concludes the tutorial on how to use the LM35 analog temperature sensor with Arduino. The sample code, schematic, and LM35 datasheet will be linked to in the description of this video. Thank you for watching, and be sure to keep an eye out for future videos on how to utilize TI's sensor library with Arduino.